Today I'm going to continue installing seat belts in the mule. Last time I installed the driver's side, slapped it right in. Piece of cake. I didn't know what to expect when installing seat belts into a car because I've never installed seat belts in it. After installing the driver's side, there's a few things I wish I did differently. So this time I'm gonna be a little bit more careful. And then I'm gonna move the steering wheel to the passenger side because I'm not sitting in the driver's side seat with a seatbelt like that. Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. The driver's side turned out great. The retractor is in the perfect position so the seatbelt doesn't rub on the side of the car. The top worked out good because the bolt fit right in the OEM hole. And the bottom strap bolted right into the same hole as the retractor did. That's the part that might not be safe. I'm sure it's fine. But I'd like to CNC cut a nice plasma plate to sit over that area to thicken it up and make it DOT approved for a 300 pound fat bitch for the passenger side. I have to haul my friend's mom off to dinner tomorrow night.
Shut the fuck up, nigga.
My calculations are correct. The way these seat belts are configured now, it should fully support a 250-pound man in a 90-mile-an-hour head-on collision. Guaranteed. It'll hold his fat ass in there, but he may have a fuel cell shoved up his boner hole. Ever had a fuel cell in your dick hole and an air tank up your ass? At the same time? No. While strapped into the fucking... Well, Rafa's mom has. Since I still don't have the proper tip for my Astro nut cert tool, I need to weld a nut on the back of the seatbelt retractor. I went about it differently this time. I welded the nut to the washer first, and then welded that to the back side of the retractor through the provided retractor holes. Looks like a genius made it. I wanted to just stick a nut cert in this retractor hole. Put it in the back, drill a hole in the body, stick a bolt in through the bottom strap bracket into the nut cert hole. It would have been so easy. But I should get that tool tomorrow when I don't need it. Ow. tomorrow I can use the nut cert tool for the buckle side of the straps and the two rear seat bolts for each seat. Because right now I can't get my nuts under the car. Jamming my nuts under there, I can't get to my nuts. I can jam my nuts up under the car, but I can't poke them through the hole, the seat hole. I can't poke my nuts through the nut hole. Can I help you? I also have all new nuts and bolts for the seats, which should finally fix up the seat bolts, because it's always been a pain in the ass to take them out and put them back in the car because I can't get to my nuts. So I'm excited to get that nut cert tool, finish up these seat belts, finish up the seats. Now that the steering wheel is fixed, I also ordered some gauges and other things we could start looking at. I want to start getting this dash mocked up and get some of the gauges in place before the dyno tune appointment. That way we have some working gauges and I can continue fabrication on the dash. Do you know what that means? I'm gonna have to face my worst fear. Robert Martinez's goddamn glove box!
These nuts.
Thank you guys for always coming back. Make sure you leave a comment. I'd love to read your feedback. Hit that thumbs up. You can find me on Twitter at Doug Bernards. I'll see you tomorrow. Support Amplified by going to soundmanca.com and picking up an iPad dash kit and Soundman merch. Go to mobilesolutions-usa.com and book your car audio training and check out their tools. And go to ct-sounds.com for some innovative car audio equipment from a company that's giving back to the community.